There's no question that over the last bunch of years, virtual meetings and online presentations and remote podcasts and interviews and all that has become extremely popular because, well, let's be honest, a lot more people are working remote, spending more time on their computers and virtually chatting with people. But sometimes you're looking for an option that allows you to do those things, but at a much higher quality. I've been using Riverside.fm for a while when it comes to hosting virtual podcasts or webinars or whatever it is, but now they've actually taken things to a whole nother level. Because now Riverside.fm can do tons of things that no other software even comes close to. Things like automatically creating social media snippets from different pieces of your content to post online with captions and graphics and branding, and also being able to take your audio and making it sound even better with AI. It's pretty impressive what they're doing now in their software. So I wanted to take this time to tell you about some of the new features Riverside.fm has that I think would be really beneficial for you, whether you're already a content creator and looking for a software that helps you create more, or potentially you're someone new who doesn't know how to make video content at all. They kind of do it for you. So let me tell you about some of the new features that I really like. One of the best features to me for Riverside.fm, specifically when it comes to recording remote podcasts or interviews or even webinars, is the fact that everything is done locally on each computer and automatically uploaded and synced for a final file that you can download. So what that means is, unlike in the past where if you were trying to host something on Zoom, for example, or some sort of meeting platform, and you record the screen, well, you're kind of really limited to what quality was happening in real time, because it's really just recording the screen and it's just showing all buffering and it's not good quality and it just doesn't look good. And so it doesn't look professional if you're actually trying to produce a really good looking quality podcast or interview. What's really cool about Riverside.fm is everything is recorded locally on each machine. So when you are having some sort of interview with someone or a podcast recording, it is recording their audio and their video locally on their computer and then uploading those files all after the fact automatically, not them having to drag and drop files in different places and upload them to different places. It just does it all for them. So when that interview is done, it has just recorded and it has put everything right online for you to access. And what's cool about that is that even if you have an internet issue of some sort, and let's just say that it starts to buffer, well, if you were recording straight through some other platform, well, then you have to worry about the fact that now it's going to be buffering all the time in that part of the clip and you can't do anything about it. Riverside.fm stores everything locally, uploads it just like you'd expect, and then you can pull those individual files all after the fact right from the source. Now, all those features with Riverside are just pretty common to them. They've been doing it for a while and that's been their bread and butter. But they've taken it a step further now in their actual Riverside.fm studio that really has been game changing and I think could be huge for people to create more content for themselves or clients, or potentially if you're a person that's making your own podcast and you need to create content for that podcast and you don't really have a lot of editing expertise. Let me show you how unbelievable the new built-in software for Riverside.fm is. Now, what's really cool about this new editing studio and all the things I'm about to show you is you don't have to actually record the stuff in Riverside.fm to be able to have these features. So for example, this video right here is a video I just did called "Which iPad Should I Buy in 2024? You can see that it's a 32-minute long video. All I had to do was just upload that file like you would with any other software. And when I go into this software now, inside here, you can now see that I have all these other options for things that I can do with this file. Now, one of the ones that I love the most is these magic clips. So I can literally just hit this generate clips button for this whole video, and you'll see that it will just get to work, right? It says finding the best moments. And in under a minute, you now see that there are 6 clips ready to edit. Now, these are just ones that it just decides on its own. You can even see that it somewhat categorizes them and tells you what it's about. Model size, capacity, and connectivity. This one's talking about faster processor and large screen. This one's talking about speaker comparison, a microphone comparison, which iPad is right for basic use. So I can go to any one of these clips. These were all, once again, just the click of a button, and I can go right in here to edit. You'll see that my entire transcript of the video is on the side here, so you can see specifically what section that it decided to take itself. And you can see that it started right here with when it comes to any device, whether it's an iPad or computer, boom, I start talking about this. Maybe I say, for example, that I want this to be a 9x16 and I want to just change the layout and I actually want it to fill instead. Maybe I even wanted to create my own brand if I have a logo or background, for example. So if I wanted to create a branding background that I've, you know, created for myself in the past, I could do something like that. I could create some other look if I choose. I can make it look kind of however I want. I can click one button here and I can just look at all these caption options that it just has designed for me. So maybe I want to just choose this one right here. And because it already has the whole transcription, you can see that it just immediately will caption exactly as I'm talking. So if I hit play here.
When it comes to any device, whether that's an iPad or a computer, obviously your use case is going to be the biggest factor into which iPad is probably right for you.
But I can take that text if I decide I want the text to actually be down here instead, and then it just obviously...
Depending on how you plan to use your iPad and even how long you plan to...
But what's amazing is these are just 5 clips that it randomly chose, obviously. I can also, if I decided, hey, actually this part right here is also very important, I don't want to skip that, I can just take that and I can hit these little dots and say create new edit specifically in that. Or I could actually say, let's add this section to it. And it will add that specific section. Maybe I see this part of the clip and I say, you know what, I actually don't want this part to be included in that. I can just go ahead and hit delete and boom, now it's gone and the clip ends before it even gets to that section. I can go right here to AI producer and I can actually maybe even set the pace. If I had someone, for example, that said a lot of ums and ahs and I wanted the pace to be a little bit better, I can have it actually smooth some of those out and remove certain pauses. Now you won't see that it's removing many pauses from me because I have already edited this video, so I've edited those things out. But if you had a conversation with someone that was saying a lot of ums and ahs, it can just speed up the pace and make it more energetic and fast paced like you would for TikTok, for example. And that's super valuable. Or maybe the quality of the audio wasn't that good in general. I can hit apply and it will actually just automatically use AI to enhance the audio that is in that video. So I recorded this video in a good quality, so obviously I don't have to worry about that much, but if you recorded it in a not ideal circumstance or a room, you can hit one button, it'll just enhance that audio track and make it sound like studio quality, like basically no matter what mic you use, which is crazy.
This is Riverside Magic Audio. Right now, I'm recording in a busy coffee shop. There's lots of background noise going on, conversations, dishes clanging, and yet when you enable Magic Audio here on the webpage, you'll see how it cleans up that audio, removes background noise, can remove echo, and this is all recorded with a built-in microphone on my laptop.
So if I want, I could just take this section that it didn't even include in this specific clip, and I can just click these 3 little dots, and I can put create new edit, and then boom, it opens up a new section, just like that previous one, with just that new specific section, with the same style and the same look, and now it has this
YouTube
section. Boom.
Videos in my bed.
And there's another clip. So I can literally just take all these different sections and just make tons of micro content that it automatically does all the work for me. The captioning, the branding. If I wanna take this specific clip and say, actually, I wanna make it square for LinkedIn or X or Instagram, whatever, or if I wanna make this a YouTube version instead, or Shorts or Reels or TikToks, all perfectly formatted. I can change this, I can instantly go into this, and then if I decide, hey, I actually wanna make this smaller because, well, you know, it can be a little smaller on that platform rather than this platform, whatever, no time whatsoever. So even if you do video production for a living, what's amazing about this new back end of Riverside is that you can use it to make tons of content on any videos that you even already edited yourself, which is awesome because it's important to post a lot of content out there. So you can literally just go through all these things that it already chose for you and hit one button and export them, and you have all this additional content. But if you don't like what it chose, you can just pull certain things back in or move it, but you can edit entirely based on the transcript, which makes it super, super simple. Anytime that there's a software that allows me to create more content faster, I'm all for it. But if that software also has additional great features like those remote recordings and high quality webinars and all that stuff, like, that's just a super win to me. So I could go on and on all about the different stuff that it does. But as you can see, there are a ton of features in Riverside.fm, and they're taking it a step further by now making this like an editor that you can edit content in it directly and make more content for yourself. And that is super valuable in this day and age, because you gotta create content to get out there and become known. So if you're interested in trying Riverside.fm, there's a link down below. Go ahead and check it out. I really think you'd find it valuable. This is the first software I found that is actually really good for someone that's already doing this work and wants to have another software that helps them make more content, or for someone that has zero editing expertise at all, because you can just edit with transcriptions and click a few buttons and it does all the work and makes your audio sound better and makes your video sound better. And it just takes the legwork out of creating content. Hopefully this video is helpful. I think this software is awesome and you probably should give it a try, because I've been finding it super valuable.